Thank you all for coming. I'm Clifford Barnett, and I'm going to be talking to you today about opening doors and teen real talk. And so to help me, I'm going to need you to help me, okay? I want to first start off by telling anybody here see the movie Monsters, Inc.? Remember Monsters, Inc.? What was the name of the little girl? Boo. The name of the little girl was Boo. And you remember, one of the things, her problem was that they destroyed her door. She didn't have a way to get back to where she needed to go. And so they were working on getting the door. Now, the other thing that happened with Boo was that Boo was afraid of monsters. Yeah, monsters. He was afraid of monsters. And what did the monsters do to make her afraid? They were screaming. They were scaring her. All right, what I want to talk about for just a moment, think for a minute. What are some of the things that scare you? And I know you'll say, I'm a man, nothing scares me, I'm bad. No, but what are some of the things that we look at around our lives that may scare us, okay? I saw your hand up. And say, okay, and I like the way you raise your hand, okay? That way we'll talk. Ostriches, okay? What scares you?
Nothing really scares me, but people can, like, jump out and scare me.
Okay. Okay, I'll come to you in a minute. Yes, sir. Failure, okay, I'm coming to you. Hold on. Yes, sir.
Parents.
All right, failure parents, yes.
Dying.
Say it again.
Dying.
Okay, dying can be a fearful. Okay, yes, sir.
Height.
Cloud.
Spiders.
I gave him, he's got it. Okay. Snakes, absolutely, snakes. Bears. Say it again.
Bloody Mary.
Bloody Mary. Okay. Yes, dear.
Hell.
Say it again.
Hell.
Hell.
Yeah.
Okay.
Death.
Death of loved ones. Sure.
Future.
Your future. Okay. Right. Okay. Now listen. Gave me some great thoughts about what scares you. Some of the things and things I think about doors. One of the first things I was going to ask you to do was think about for a minute how many doors are in your house. Think about it for a minute. I mean, a lot. You've got the kitchen, the bedroom, the bathrooms. And the thing about doors is that doors are used sometimes to keep bad things out, keep us safe. But also, if we let the wrong things in, it could affect us and hurt us. So let's talk for a minute about some of the things that make us safe. Can you think of something? What makes you safe? What are some of the things that make you safe? Yes, sir.
A lock.
A lock. Okay, cool. Having a door that locks. Okay, yes. A gun may make you safe, okay.
Feel comfortable, being more comfortable with somebody.
Okay. Being protected, being comfortable around people and being protected. Yes, sir.
Family.
All right, family is a good thing. Yes.
A couple of canines,
okay.
Your home.
Okay. All right, so let's talk. Yes, sir.
Father.
Your father, absolutely. A bodyguard. A dog? Oh, God. Okay, cool. God. Anything else that keeps you comfortable? So let's talk then and do some real talk about things that scare us, but also we're going to talk about things that make us safe. And you've talked about things that scare you. When I think about things that scare you, I want to share a poem with you, and then we'll talk about this poem. The poem is written by a lady named Marianne Williamson. Marianne Williamson is a lady who wanted to do a legislation across the country where we have a peace committee. But she writes this poem. Now, this poem, some people say that Nelson Mandela quoted it when he came out of South Africa and he was inaugurated as the president, but he really didn't. If you ever watch the movie Victus, which is about Nelson Mandela, they'll even quote it in the movie, but he really didn't. And if you ever watched the movie I've got the movie about a basketball team, and the coach quotes the Sioux. But it's written by this lady named Marianne Williamson, and she writes it in her book called A Return to Love. Now listen to the words, and then we'll talk about it. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Do you know it? Come on, come read it for me. All right, come on, you got it right here. You can read it. Come on. Watch this. Come on, I need help. Come on. What's your name? Isaiah. Give Isaiah a hand. Josiah. Give Josiah a hand. All right. Yeah, Josiah's a man. Now what? Listen to this. Say it loud, Josiah.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us.
Say it loud. Let's slow down something. Here, go. Doing great.
We ask ourselves who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous. Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. There's nothing enlightening about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine as children do. We were born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. It is not just in some of us, it is in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others.
Yes, sir. Give him a hand. Good job, man. Thank you, Josiah. Okay. Now, hit your hand up. Okay. So what? Let's start this poem. And when I started this poem, Josiah said, cool. He went on and started quoting it, okay? Listen, he says, she says, our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. What that means is that my deepest fear is not that I can't do. My deepest fear might be that I could blow the top off, that I could be fantastic, I could be marvelous, because that's how we have been made. That's how you're made. Now watch. It's our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, and we always say this, who am I to be brilliant? Who am I to be gorgeous or talented or fabulous? And actually, we ought to answer, who am I not to be? Who am I not to be the bomb? Who am I not to be to walk with swagger? Who am I not to be? Who are you not to be to have confidence and be sure of what you do? Just like the brother talked about this morning, about the grass coming through the cement, okay? You are gifted, you are talented, you have many gifts. You're so gifted and talented that you can be gorgeous, talented, and fabulous. Now, and understand, gorgeous doesn't just mean how you look on the outside, okay? Because I know some people that look really good on the outside, but then their personality and their inward, and so it's what's on the inside that really makes the difference of what people see on the outside, okay? So, watch. Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. You're playing small does not serve the world. Let me give an example of playing small. When the kids around you don't do their homework and you don't do it, that's playing small. When you have done your homework already and the teacher says pass it in, but your buddy says, I ain't passing mine in, and then you take yours and hide it and don't pass it in, that's playing small. Another good example of playing small. People that are tall, oftentimes, tall folks, especially in middle school, they'll find themselves, when they sit in a chair, let me borrow your chair, thanks. What tall people do sometimes, when they sit in a chair, instead of sitting up like this, what tall people do, watch, they'll slouch down. Anybody know why they're slouching down? Okay, yes sir.
Wait, what'd you say?
Why do they slouch down? Why do tall people slouch?
I chill, like I'm chilling.
Feel like you're chilling? Okay. Why
so
did it go?
So they can feel equal to everyone else.
Bingo!
Oh, good. In class, everybody asks me to sit down, so I'm like,
tall,
so I can
be
like this in the chair.
Okay. All right. But most of the time, people that are tall slouch down because they want to be equal with everybody else. Okay. And I want to challenge you that you don't have to be equal. That's what I want to talk about in Straight Talk. You don't have to be equal. I want to challenge you. Thank you, sir. I want to challenge you that you're gifted. That if you're tall, that's a good thing. And I don't have to shrink down to be equal with anyone else. Got to be real careful of that. Yes, sir.
See, to me, I don't really care about being equal. I care about being myself.
Okay.
About matching other people.
Good for you. That's good for you. That's a good answer. Yes, sir. That's a good answer. You don't want to care about, you want to match, you want to be a partner about you. Okay? So you got to understand then, as he talks about this, that we are meant to shine. We're born to manifest the glory of God within us. And it's not just in some of us, but it's in every last one of us. And so just like the grass coming through the concrete. No matter what your obstacles are, your challenges are, there's still a way for you to shine. Okay? And so you're not limited by what has happened to you in the past. You're limited by what you choose to do with what happened to you in the past and how you live your life right now. Okay? So as we talk about opening doors, it's what we do that opens the doors for others as well as ourselves. Okay? All right. Now, here's what I want you to do. I want you to think about, when you hear the word an open door, what does that bring to your mind? An open door. Yes, sweetheart.
A fresh start.
A fresh start. Okay, good word. Okay?
Walking in.
Walking in, okay?
New opportunities.
New opportunities. All right. Watch this. Anybody here need a fresh start? Anybody here ever needed a fresh start?
I need to get baptized.
You need to get baptized? Okay, we'll make sure that we talk to Sean about that. Okay? Sure. Now watch. So let's talk for a minute. What do I have to do when the door is open? Or how do I get to an open door? What do I need to do to get to an open door?
Turn the knob.
Turn the knob? Okay. But let's say, and right. Okay? Good point. And now understand though, watch. When we talk about the open door, we're not just talking about literally a door. We're not just talking about this door. But we're talking about opportunities and things to do. Yes, sir?
You need to find somebody who can help you get to that opportunity to help you open that door.
Okay. All right. Find someone who will help you do that, okay?
To feel like you're brave to move on with that and open that door. Come out as a victory. Instead of closing, keeping that door closed and not going to it because of that bad thing, you're not going to make it.
Okay. All right. Cool. Anybody else? What do you do when you see an open door? How do you handle an open door, the opportunities? I think, yes, sir, Josiah. Yes, ma'am.
You thrive.
Say it again.
You thrive.
You say it again.
Thrive.
Thrive through it. Okay, go through it. Yes.
Sometimes you need to proceed with caution and make sure that open door is the door you need to do.
Okay, good point. Okay, he says sometimes you have to proceed with caution to make sure that that open door is what you want to go through. And that's a great word. There are different lights, red, green, and yellow. Right? Sometimes in life, you really have to stop and invest what's going on. Sometimes the green light comes on and you can go straight through. Then other times, there are times in your life when there's the yellow where you need to be cautious and make sure that it's the right thing you want to do. I saw a hand over here. Okay? So opportunities. Let's talk for a minute then about selecting friends. Because you said one of the first things you want to do is make sure you get the right friends. Do this for me. Take your fingers, your index fingers, and bend them like this, your pointers. Bend them like this. Okay. Now, the sign language, the sign for friend is this. You take one and you hook it, and then you reverse it and hook the other way. That's a sign for friend. That's a sign for friend, okay? You hook one, that's a sign for friend. John Maxwell says this. He says, the things that's gonna help you will be the stuff that you read and the people you hang out with. Right. How many of you ever heard this statement before? You're starting to act just like. You ever heard that? Okay, you sound like just like so-and-so, yes? Who normally says that?
Your parents.
Yeah, your parents, right? Okay, right. Or your family. Now watch. Question for me. Is it true or false?
True.
Is it true?
Mm-hmm.
All right. It can be false. Why? How? A little louder. You guys listening? Okay. Okay. All right. Cool. So it could be false in the sense that I may not be copying them for them. They may be copying for me. All right. Cool. What else? What else can you do about that statement? You're starting to act just like. How do you pick your friend? Yes.
It's perceived on how other people view how you're acting.
Okay, it's perceived, okay, on how other people view how you're acting. But listen, one person said this, that perception to some people is reality. Meaning this, watch. If I walked in the room and somebody said to you, somebody whispered in your ear, hey, don't trust that guy because he steals stuff. Okay? Somebody put that in your ear. As soon as I walk in the room and I look at this piece of paper, what's the first thing you're going to start thinking? Bingo. Okay? Even though I just took the paper. Okay? So you've got to watch out for perception. Okay? Because perception is for some people, reality. All right? All right, now, so let's talk for a minute about how do I select my friends? How do you select them? Yes. Okay, I have to be kind and fun. Okay, yes, ma'am, we'll come back.
You want somebody that acts about the same as you.
Okay, you want somebody that acts the same as you, okay? Good statement, yes. Say it again for me, I'm sorry. Okay, good motivator, somebody's gonna help you with problem solving, sure.
You want somebody that has the same qualities as you do.
Okay. Somebody with the same qualities as you do. Now, and I'm gonna let you talk in a minute, Twin. Qualities, you gotta make sure that there are certain standards that you live up to, that you have when you select your friends. Because believe it or not, your friends can either help you go up or they'll bring you down. Yes, sir. A person you get along with, sure, okay.
A person that will help bring you up instead of bringing you down.
Okay, help bring you up instead of bringing you down. Good.
Someone that actually respects you and encourages you to do good and be helpful to others.
Okay, say that again so everybody can hear you. It's a great answer.
Okay. Yeah, say someone again. Someone who respects you for who you are and actually can encourage you to be there for others.
Okay. All right. Great answer. Yes, sir.
Get to know them before you think about calling them friends. Get to know them.
Okay.
And go up arguing with them.
Okay. Get to know them before you can call them a friend. Going back to entering in carefully, going to the same situation.
Somebody that set good standards.
Okay. Somebody who sets good standards. Okay.
Somebody who's different than you.
Somebody who's different than you. Okay. Why is somebody different? I'm just curious. So let me ask you this. This is a dumb question because I'm just kind of like that kind of dumb guy for a minute. So if I don't smoke, do I want to hang out with people that smoke?
No.
If I don't do drugs, do I want to hang out with people that do drugs?
No.
So different in the sense that maybe we may have different talents or skills, but we learn from each other. Okay, like that. Yes, sir.
Someone you can fall back on when you need help.
Okay, someone you can fall back on when you need help. Okay? Anybody remember the sign for help? Show me the sign for help. Show me the sign for help. Here you go. All right, help. You need help. Somebody do need help. Because all of us need help sometimes. Even the adults that are in the room, we all find that we need help. Now, so the key then, I think, one of the keys to selecting friends is to know what we call is the non-negotiables. Meaning, if a person does this, then you're not going to be my friend. Now, being a friend means I hang out with you. You have to go to school with everybody, but you don't have to hang out with everyone. You understand? You don't have to hang out with everyone. Okay. Anything else that you would do to select friends? Anything else that you would do to select friends? Yes, sir. Trust them. You got to trust them. Okay, if you got a friend, you got to trust them, okay? Sir?
Make sure they hang out with the right crowd and they stay out of trouble.
Okay, make sure they hang out with the right crowd and then they stay out of trouble. All right. Anybody else?
Facebook.
What about Facebook?
You look at the post, email.
Okay, cool. And I'm glad you brought Facebook, because let me tell you what employers do. Watch. If, for example, you went to try to get a job, let's say if you want to try to work at Winn-Dixie or something, what people will do, watch, this is what they'll do, is they'll take your name and all that kind of stuff, and then some employers will go back and look at your Facebook. And they'll look at what kind of stuff comes in your Facebook. Now, here's the thing I've talked with some teens about this, is that sometimes some of the people that are friends of a friend connect with my Facebook. And sometimes they'll send some things through on my Facebook that's not appropriate. Okay? And if an employer was looking at that, they would perhaps not hire me because of what was placed on Facebook. So you gotta really be careful what you allow people to put on your Facebook page. All right, good point. All right, so anything else you would do about selecting friends? Anything else? Selecting friends. So if we talk about opening doors, then we talk about opportunities. I'll come to you in a second. We're talking about opportunities to do better things. That's the whole key to opening doors. And Teen Talk, the idea is that there are opportunities to open better doors. Now watch, here's what we gotta do. I think that one of the challenges we have is you gotta plan some things. Now, here's what I understand. If you don't plan something, somebody's gonna plan something for you. And usually, when people plan things for you, it may be to their interest and not necessarily yours. So, what I mean by that then is that we need to take the time to plan for things that we wanna do. Anybody ever got in trouble before? You ever got in trouble? When do you normally get in trouble? At school, all right. When you're with your friends, okay, anybody else? When?
I'm gonna go back to that planning thing.
Say it louder.
You can't plan everything in your life. There's some things that are gonna happen that's unplanned.
Okay, absolutely. You can't plan everything that happens in your life. And so, just like the grass coming through the concrete, you have to adjust to some things. You're right, you can't plan, but however, if I've got an idea of what's gonna happen, it's a lot better. I know, you're right, you cannot plan for everything that happens in your life. No one can, no one can. Some things that happen in life just happen, but you gotta learn to adjust to those things that happen. Yes, sir. Anything you do that's bad, you get in trouble for it. Yeah. Well, no, I'll be honest with you. Sometimes there's always consequences. And sometimes there are things that you do that sometimes you don't always get caught, but you pay for it in the long run. Okay. And that's why one of the things I was going to say behind doors is that everything you do, like say even behind a door, sometimes will become to the light. Okay. So plan, select your friends carefully. Take advantage of opportunities that are yours, and then understand this, that a lot of the open doors that you're getting to face, have an opportunity to face, understand that a number of people have made many sacrifices for you to have those open doors. Like, for example, parents and grandparents and people who've come before you have made many sacrifices for you to do some of the things that you do. Okay? All right. Anybody got any questions for me? Got any questions for me? What would you? Choose wisely your friends, prepare, plan. Anything else? What else would you do? Pardon? Just for you to do life, for you to live life, for you to make the best decision that you can. Yes?
Prioritize.
Give me an example.
If you want to go out after school that day, but you know you have homework, are you going to go out or are you going to sit down and do your homework first and then go out?
Okay, right, Doris. Things that are important, get the most time. Good for you. All right, great. Yes, sir.
So my plans after high school are to go to Navy, but if that doesn't work, my fallback, have a fallback plan.
Okay, all right. Yes, ma'am.
Time management.
Excellent. One of the things that teachers tell kids in high school, and especially when you get in college, one of the greatest challenges that they have is managing your time. Because when you are a poor manager of time, then that's one thing you can't get back. Once you waste that time, you can't get it back. You lose it, okay? So you have to be a good manager of time. As a matter of fact, when people do the senior project, in high school, every senior has to do a project. And I get the privilege of evaluating some of those projects at the end of the school year. And the thing that most of the teens tell me about doing the project was the greatest challenge was managing the time. Taking the time to do the things at the right time. Prioritizing. Putting things, because once you lose time, it's gone forever. Okay? Good point. Thank you. All right, any other questions? Thoughts?
I think one thing.
All right, thank you, Sean.
In my class, I do a debate in my literacy class at Leland Middle School, and a young lady came to me, and she was very uncomfortable with public speaking. Mm-hmm. And I told her, I said, one of the things you can do to be successful in life is to put yourself in uncomfortable, positive situations.
Okay.
So do something that's going to challenge yourself. Do something that you're not so comfortable with that's going to help you learn and grow. And through this, she wound up participating in the debate. She's such a soft-spoken young lady, but she came out like a tiger in that debate. And
wow.
Her team won the debate because of her powerful speaking voice and her thoughts. And she discovered something about herself that she never knew. And she's actually starting to turn towards being a strong public speaker. And that's something she's never discovered before. So discover things about yourself by putting yourself in uncomfortable, successful situations.
Okay. Look at the key word. Okay, in uncomfortable, successful situations, positive situations, put yourself in position where you can grow in a positive way. That's a great example. Thank you. So as you develop new friends, select your friends, select them carefully, prioritize, be a good manager of your time, because time runs out just like that. It runs out just, I promise you, it runs out just like that. And you don't get a chance to get it back, okay? So hang out with the right people and make good choices, all right? Any other questions you got? Anything else you want to share with me? Yeah. All right. Then let me share with you this little thing I do with your hand. Look at your fingers for a second. Look at your fingers and recognize that everybody has gifts. Okay? There's certain things you can do, there's certain things I can do. Everybody has gifts. As a matter of fact, give your neighbor a high five and say, I got gifts. Everybody got gifts. Everybody got gifts. Give your neighbor a high five. Everybody got gifts. Right? Don't kill them. Now, watch this. One of the things about life is this, and that's why it's really important to select friends carefully. It's because even though you have gifts, there's certain things you can do, everybody also in life has gaps. Look at your fingers again. See? You got gaps. Now watch. Give your neighbor a high five and tell them I got gaps too.
I got gaps.
All right? Now, last thing. Watch this. Last thing. It happens in football. Watch. When they play football, the center usually comes out and he stands here. Then next to the center is the guard, next to the guard is the tackle, next to the tackle is the end. And when they stand there, what they do is the center will put his arms out like this, and the tackle will put their arms out, and everybody touches fingertips because they understand that I can only cover from my arm to my fingertips. That's as far as I can cover. Okay? Because if I can't cover way over there, I can only cover from my shoulder to my fingertip. This is all I can cover, one step, okay? Now watch, when the quarterback is sacked, the reason the quarterback gets sacked, watch this, come on man, hurry up, get up grandpa, come on. The reason the quarterback gets sacked, right, is because a defensive man shoots the gap. You got me? You watch, come here, you be my defensive man, get over here. You're a linebacker, okay? And that's supposed, he and I are on the team. Do this, I'm this far. Now take a step away. Boom. Now, and he's the defensive man. He runs through the gap, look. And he sacks the quarterback because he runs through the gap. Now watch. But what happens, the closer we get to the goal, here's what they do in football. Come here. Instead of being this far apart, the goal line's defense stand is like this. They get closer because they want to protect the gap, okay? Now, and here's the secret. Here's the key. Sit up or you get slammed. Here's the key. Good job. Here's the key. Watch. In life, people are going to try to sack your quarterback. But you gotta protect your gap. Now, I said everybody has gifts, right? I give your neighbor a high five and say, I got gifts, bam. But I also have gaps. Now watch. Okay, last thing, watch this. Last thing, but one of the neat things about gifts and gaps is this. Hold your hands out again. Watch. Now, and take your gifts, hold your hands, everybody watching me. Take your gifts and fill in your neighbor's gaps. Okay, see? So, that's a sample. Watch. So, how, the way we're successful, you watching me? The way we're successful is you pull in your gaps. Now, in football, watch, and I'm finished. In football, the closer you get to your goal, the harder it is. That's why they have the 20 yards. They call that the red zone. Because the closer you get to scoring, the harder the defense is going to play. And that's why it's so important that as you get close to your goal, that you pull in friends who are going to help you to reach your goal. Because the enemy will try to stop you from getting your goal. The enemy will say, you can't make it. The enemy will say, you're too dumb. The enemy will say, you're too slow. The enemy will say, well, your dad was not in your life, so you're not going to make it. The enemy will say, you can't reach that goal. But I've come to tell you that you can. And I want you to know that all you have to do is there's times when you need a goal line defense or goal line offense where you pull in your friends closer and you go and make the goal. Here's the challenge. It's not, our deepest fear is not that we're inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we're powerful beyond measure. It is our light and not our darkness that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, or fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine as children do. We are born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. It is not just in some of us, it's in every one of us. And as we let our light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fears, our presence automatically liberates others. Challenge. Be a strong person. Challenge. Fill in the gaps of others who don't have the same gifts. Use your gifts. Plan. Be a good manager of time. Also, select your friends carefully. Last sign. The sign for select is this. Watch this. Take your right hand and put your thumb and your index finger together like you're reaching down to get a napkin and you pick it up. Watch. And that's what I want you to do. Select. Choose. Select. You select. Watch. Intentionally select your friends carefully. If you see them making bad choices, you got to select the right friends. Because the people you hang out with, well, I promise you, they will either lift you up or they will bring you down. Okay? All right. Give yourselves a round of applause.